30 years ago, Madison Nguyen became the first Vietnamese American to be elected to the San Jose City Council. Tonight, she is facing a recall. Kit Doe explains what happened to turn her former supporters against her.
This unassuming office is ground zero for one of San Jose's most bizarre stories in recent memory. It's the headquarters of the Recall Madison Committee, where volunteers work the phone 7 days a week to do just that.
Momentum is clearly on our side.
Back in 2005, when the committee was going into office, the city's first giving councilor was treated like a rock star. But then came the Little Saigon controversy late last year. Then one of the callers grabbed the door and something out of the Little Saigon, a name that has strong anti-communist symbolism. After months of protest,
oh,
the
dramatic of the
city gave in. Over the past weekend, the Little Saigon banners were hung, and it looked like the controversy was over.
There's really not much to keep on fighting for. They should claim victory and move on.
Nguyen says she's disappointed but not surprised the recall effort got this far, and says the county certified more than 5,000 petitions by verifying a small sample.
And you don't think that all those signatures are valid?
I'm not saying that, but I can't say that those signatures are valid either, because nobody ever looked at them.
The recall election could cost up to $500,000, and it comes at a time when the city is tightening its belt and cutting back on millions of dollars of services like tree pruning and reducing library hours. Regulars like Robert Souza have noticed.
The hours seem to be shortened for some reason. I don't know why.
The question is, can you put a cost on accountability for local politicians?
The Recall Madison Committee says it's no longer about Little Saigon anymore.
The Little Saigon issue was really systematic of a deep level of disconnect that Madison Nguyen has between her and her constituents.
There are certain difficult decisions that sometimes I make that will make people very happy and others very unsatisfied. And if that's the basis for a recall effort, then obviously something's wrong with our system.
That was Kit Doe reporting. San Jose residents will be able to vote on the recall in a special election March 3rd, 2019.